Hey there, Star Wars fans, back again with another FlyGuy.net figure review. This one is a request from Dole Orange Juice. You asked for a review when we did the review of the cabinets all over the collection. You picked out Hermie Odle from Return of the Jedi, and here he is. So this guy, I've been doing my research on Wikipedia, was one thing certainly we know of. We've seen this guy. He's in Jabba's palace briefly. He is a Baragwin, I believe, is his species, and he is a weapons maker for Jabba. But enough of me spouting Wikipedia. Let's give you a kind of usual HD look at this guy. Let me get the focus going properly. There we go. This was a really unusual figure by Hasbro to make. The detail on the guy, I'll take the cloaks off. The material, it's the very first time I've ever seen Hasbro give us such abundance of material and of a really good kind of quality that was very movie-like. So there's not a great deal to show you around, but hopefully you can see, if you've got this in HD, this goes all the way up, you'll be able to see the cloth-like material is nothing like we've had before. If you look at general figures like Jedi with robes, the material's okay, but it tends to have a kind of, there's no other word for it, a kind of poofy kind of like puffness on it. And it bounces up a lot, whereas this material is very like Hessian or some other kind of material. That's it really wraps around the figure. But a great looking piece. The one thing I love about this guy, and I should say actually, this came as part of the anniversary collection, the 30th anniversary collection, about 2.5, probably longer, years ago, maybe three and a half years ago, and this figure came out there. But the one thing that I love about this guy is his mouth and his tongue. As we even have, as you can see in there, the roof of his mouth has ridges and ripples and elements to it. There's ridges even on the back of his tongue. It's completely, really well done by Hasbro. Not a feature you would really expect to see in a child's toy. And also you can have him with his kind of, there you go, he's just got his bottom lip hanging out. He looks utterly gross in Return of the Jedi. He really is. That fat bottom lip that's hanging out everywhere, and it's pretty boggin'. But I kind of like it. I like the fact that Hasbro made something so unusual, so ugly, and so much plastic. It's pretty amazing. So he comes with this skiff guard-like, pretty unique, I think, as well. Silver chrome. And it's very hard to get his hands, I believe, because it's been in there for a couple of years. But I'll try. There we go. So again, just a little bit of a close-up on that. All silver all the way across with a small piece of, and again, really good textured and done in paintwork, a kind of brown leather wrap that he's got around for a handle piece and a small pike piece at the bottom. So as I said, the figure comes with all this wrapping around him. So you'll see if I, as much as I can, if I begin to undo this, how much this guy comes with. Huge amounts. He's got a cape. It's a kind of a super Hermie as he flies across the screen. Tons of material that wraps around, and there's also this green piece here. It's actually, as you'll see, stuck into the headpiece on there, so it doesn't come loose. Otherwise, I think it might be pretty difficult to manage it. But the way that Hasbro put the figure together, you'll see the cloth. Whoops, the cloth has been stuck around his head, and it's again, when you look at the movie and the reference, that's kind of the way it was. So even underneath that, Hasbro have given a silver belt buckle and all sorts of detail at the back. Let me just try and show you the paintwork. The amount of paintwork in this guy is absolutely massive. I'll compare it to a figure in a minute and you'll see what's involved. But this huge humpback kind of guy and all this paintwork that ultimately sits under the cape. So Hasbro really did an amazing job on this. Lots of love and dedication from the true fanboys there for going to town on this. So just for comparison, let me just show you a Stormtrooper. So he's huge, absolutely massive. Very, very large figure. And surprisingly again, and I know everybody probably on this channel or the podcast we've got, hears me say the word articulation, which means it's time for a drink. Unbelievably, this guy has some excellent articulation for such a huge figure that you can't do much with. He has articulation in the feet. That's just unheard of. I mean, recently the Nikto Guard that came out as the Toys R Us exclusive again on our channel. You can find the review on there. That didn't even have articulation from the waist below it. So to get this guy back then, I think Hasbro had some money back in those days, and they decided to do some of these good figures. So he hasn't came out again. I'm sure Hasbro will go back and do this guy in the vintage collection. It would be criminal not to have this come out as the vintage collection again. So I have my hopes you will see this if you've not picked this up. Hang out for it. You will get it. I'm sure you will. There's no way they wait till this bother of making this mold and they're not going to do it again. But as I mentioned, I'm trying to talk about articulation. It's so big here. There's articulation. Let's work from the bottom up. There's articulation in the feet. There's no knees, but it obviously does move at the hips. But we also have articulation in the waist. He obviously has his articulation in the tongue. That must be a first for a Star Wars figure, articulated tongue. He also rotates his head. So it's a very strange looking Hermie. And he has pretty good, fairly ball jointed arms, which is just, again, unbelievable for a figure of this size. It's not something you get on a lot of figures. When you think back at the Power of the Force days, also articulation in the wrists there as well. So a phenomenal figure that way from the articulation standpoint. But again, when you realize some of the Power of the Force figures that we've had for many years, to get something like this with all this plastic is, as I said, pretty damn amazing. So Return of the Jedi character, Hermie Odle, fairly hard to find on eBay that when I've looked, but Dole Orange Juice, you wanted a review, you got a review. Hermie Odle, great figure, and one I think you should really add into your collection, particularly when I can finally get my hands on a Jabba the Hutt at a decent price, the Jabba's Throne, and he will look particularly good with that collection. So there we go. That's it, Hermie Odle, and leave us a comment. Did you get this figure? Did you find it? Can you find it? How much is it for you? Did you like it? Did you hate it? Do you know of any other figures that has an articulated tongue? We'd love to know. So drop us a comment or put something on Facebook, and we'll see you real soon for another Star Wars figure review. Cheers.